had been burned down, and the wives and the children were gone. Somebody say amen. But you know, when I come as I research to study for this particular message, there are some very pertinent and relevant in the name Ziklag. So Ziklag basically means a winding road. And what you have to understand the significance of is that life is a winding road. It's not a straight road. It's not like I-20. Many times life has things that confront you that you didn't see coming around the corner. How many of you have been blindsided by things that confronted you? If you had saw it coming, you could have prepared yourself for it. But there was something that caught you when you were not aware. It's nothing like somebody that walks close to you. You're ready for it if it's your enemy. But many times when your friend is the one that has a dagger pointed at your back, it's something difficult then because you are not prepared for them. Somebody say amen. Yeah. So, in this text, you find David, and he came back, and all of the winding road had brought himself to Ziklag. You know, I feel the anointing of the Lord in here this morning. Had brought them to Ziklag, and once they surveyed the land, they came to realize that everything they valued was gone. There were no wives, and there were no children. And all the men in David, they began to cry and weep until they did not have any more power to cry. You know, it's a Western thing where men are seen as weak if they cry. But if you look at the Middle Eastern countries, even if you have watched history unfold in Egypt, you saw men in the street wailing because there were no inhibitions concerning the shedding of tears. I beg for the day for the man realizes that his manhood is not threatened by the presence of tears. I can cry. That does not make me less, you know, any less a man. Why don't somebody say amen up in here? You've got to understand that God, it is so amazing that God instilled a therapeutic value in every tear that falls from your eye. You've got to understand that there are two kinds of tears. Do you know, basically, we cry every day. There is water that comes down through your filthy tear glands to water your eyes. God is an awesome God. So every time you bat your eyebrows, it's like a windshield wiper wiping off the dirt and the dust that has accumulated. What a mighty God we serve. This is why the writer said, we're so fearfully and wonderfully made. So every time you blink your eye, that windshield wiper just knocks away the dust and all of the debris that may have accumulated on your eye. And you've got to understand the importance of those constant tears that flow down your face. I feel like preaching in here today. And that is the tear that is the result of emotional stress and emotional strain. And then when somebody is in emotional pain, we'll find ourselves crying. How many of us have had something that blindsided you and hurt you so bad? It hurt you to your core and you started crying. And one thing about men, most times when we cry, we like to go somewhere and cry in private because we're not comfortable shedding tears in public. But oh, I want to tell you something. And I hope that after you hear what I've got to tell you, you'll have a different revelation concerning the power of tears. Give your neighbor a high five and say, neighbor, this is the last battle before the blessing. Oh my God, I came to talk to somebody this morning. God told me to tell you, get ready, because the dam is about to break. It's been held up a long time, and you've been wondering where in the world God is. But God told me to shake yourself, pull yourself together. You wake up in the morning looking for a fight. You don't know what it's like to have a peaceful day because every time you turn around, there's a new devil to fight. Somebody say, oh! But there is a therapeutic value associated with the shedding of tears. There is when we cry as a result of emotional pain. Studies have shown that there is a hormone in the tears that are connected to emotional pain that are not present in the regular tears that water the eye. Oh my God, I feel like preaching here. Adrenal corticotropic hormone. That's the hormone that's in the tears when you shed based on emotional pain. And it has been proven that this hormone in those emotional tears are hormones that are connected with high blood pressure. They're connected with heart disease and many other physical maladies. So what you got to understand about crying is that when you're going through something emotional and you begin to cry, dealing with a lot of emotional stress and a lot of emotional pain that they've not come to grips with. And were they not able to cry, they would lose their minds. So baby, I want to tell you something. If you feel like you want to cry, cry on. If you feel like you want to shed some tears, don't feel bad about crying, because God is the one that gave you the ability to cry. God is the one that gave you the ability to call that release to come into your life. This is why. This is why when you cry, you feel better. You ever notice how much better you feel when you cry? The reason you feel better is because you've gotten rid of all of those toxins in your life. Oh, some of you ain't nothing wrong with it. You just need a good cry. You just need to go somewhere, close the door, and cry like a baby. Cry until your tears lock under your face. Cry until the snot roll. Cry until you feel better. Somebody.